afternoon, and welcome to Our Lady of Peace Parish.
Singing, and of course no hymnals in your pews and things like that. So again, we just thank you for being here. Thank you for your continued patience and understanding today. So as we finally enter into this sacred liturgy, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, mighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, and the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that the splendor of your glory may shine forth upon us, and that by the bright rays of the Holy Spirit, the light of your light may confirm the hearts of those born again by your grace. You are Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When the time for Pentecost was fulfilled, they were all in one place together. And suddenly there came from the sky a noise like a strong driving wind, and it filled the entire house in which they were. Then there appeared to them tongues as of fire, which parted and came to rest on each one of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in different tongues as the Spirit enabled them to proclaim. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven staying in Jerusalem. At this sound, they gathered in a large crowd, but they were confused, because each one heard them speaking in his own language. They were astonished, and in amazement they asked, "Are not all these people who are speaking Galileans? Then how does each of us hear them in his native language? We are Parthians, Medes, and Elamites, inhabitants of Mesopotamia, Judea, Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the districts of Libya near Cyrene, as well as travelers from Rome, both Jews and converts to Judaism, Cretans and Arabs, yet we hear them speaking in our own tongues of the mighty acts of God." The word of the Lord. The Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth.
Lord,
send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord, my God, you are great indeed. How manifold are your works, O Lord. The earth is full of your creatures.
Lord,
send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. May the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord be glad in his works. Pleasing to him be my theme. I will be glad in the Lord.
Lord,
send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. If you take away their breath, they perish and return to their dust. When you send forth your spirit, they are created, and you renew the face of the earth.
Lord,
send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, no one can say Jesus is Lord except by the Holy Spirit. There are different kinds of spiritual gifts, but the same Spirit. There are different forms of service, but the same Lord. There are different workings, but the same God who produces all of them in everyone. To each individual, the manifestation of the Spirit is given for some benefit. As a body is one, though it has many parts, and all of the parts of the body, though many, are one body, so also Christ. For in one Spirit, we were all baptized into one body, whether Jews or Greeks, slaves or free persons, and we were all given to drink of one Spirit. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked, where the disciples were, for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Again, it's a joy to be with you this evening. First, thinking, what, 2.5 months, it's very different to preach to an empty church. It's good to see some people here today. I'm sure that many of us have grown during these past few weeks. Maybe we've grown our hair. I have. It's kind of depressing when your mom says, "I like your curls." I'm sure many of us have asked a lot of questions during these weeks. Will things go back to normal as they were? Why is this happening to us? Today, we're in very good company with the disciples, as we heard in the Acts of the Apostles and in John's Gospel. In John's Gospel, we hear that the disciples are locked up. They're terrified. They're afraid. They fear that the Lord is no longer with them. But the Lord enters into that doubt. The Lord enters into that, dare I say, even depression. The Lord gives that peace to those confused disciples. But it's not just there. The Lord doesn't just leave it there, if you will. But the Holy Spirit, as we saw in the Acts of the Apostles, the Holy Spirit enlivens them. What a good and daily reminder for us that the Holy Spirit has been enlivening us during this time, that the Holy Spirit breathes into the church every day. And that the church must never be afraid of the joys and the challenges that face us. Every generation in the church and outside the church has had to face those changes. When we learn to face those changes, we know that this is where the Lord wants to lead us, that the Holy Spirit is always pushing us in the church forward. Now, will things go back to what they were? Probably some things. I don't know what that would be. Will some things change for good? Probably. In the bigger picture of things? Probably. That's okay. The Lord wants us to learn from our past. But at the same time, the Lord does not want us to be prisoners of nostalgia.
The Lord wants us to take the goodness of the past, to learn from them, to move forward in that peace that God wants to give us. As we enter this, I should say rather, as we finish this long Lent, in a way, it's so appropriate that we celebrate around the altar the Lord. Just asking and bringing those questions to the Lord. You know, Lord, what were those struggles during these months for me? Nothing to be ashamed of. What were those struggles for me? What were those areas in my life that I learned to grow more confident in? Those are very appropriate questions for us to answer today. So as we kick off this first weekend of public worship during Pentecost, let's ask the Holy Spirit to continue to be with our parish, that we may never be afraid of where the Lord is leading us, and that we may never be afraid to look at those new ways that the Lord is leading our old but beautiful church. Welcome to Pentecost.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God. God not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and he came in. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He is ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The Holy Spirit manifests Christ to us, recalls his words, and opens our minds to the Paschal mystery, rejoicing in the Spirit.
That the Holy Spirit, who makes present the mystery of Christ, will reconcile all people and bring them into communion with the Church. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, will show his richness to all those in need. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Holy Spirit continue to strengthen Father Dooley, our shepherd, on the occasion of his fifth anniversary of ordination to the priesthood. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let all relationships in our own lives be made holy through the gift of the Holy Spirit, the bond of love and the Blessed Trinity. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
for healing and justice for those who have experienced violence and racism. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the marginalized, the sick, the doubting, and those on the verge of despair, that the peace of the Spirit will bring them new life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, all the poor souls in purgatory, and for Tom Ridnour, for whom this Mass intention is for, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving Father, bless us with the sevenfold gifts of your Holy Spirit, and let our lives manifest all the fruits of the Holy Spirit. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of his holy church.
Pour out upon these gifts the blessing of your Spirit, we pray, O Lord, so that through them your church may be imbued with such love that the truth of your saving mystery may shine forth for the whole world. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For bringing your Paschal mystery to completion, you bestowed the Holy Spirit today on those who have made your adopted children by uniting them to your only begotten Son. This same Spirit, as the Church came to earth, opened to all peoples the knowledge of God and brought together the many languages of the earth in profession of the one faith. Therefore, overcome with Paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers of the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." And minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Robert, our Bishop, and all the clergy, remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power, and glory of
the Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance.
accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
4:30 p.m. Saturday Mass, we're going to continue to record and stream our Mass for our parishioners and our hometown who have been with us. And special thanks to all the summers. We'll be entering the church actually here pretty soon. He's been our IT guy here at Our Lady of Peace. And one of the things that we do is we pray a prayer of spiritual communion and just to unite ourselves with those who are watching this Mass. We'll be doing that new tradition here for just our Saturday, 4:30.
My Jesus, I believe that you are in the Blessed Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I long for you in my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at me spiritually to my heart, as though you have already come. I embrace you and unite myself entirely to you, never permitting to be separated from you.
These gifts we have consumed benefit us, O Lord. We may always be aflame with the same Spirit whom you wondrously poured out on your apostles. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And before final blessing, this is a note that ushers will be dismissing kind of section by section, just to ensure social distancing. So once the procession is finished, we'll dismiss kind of by sections, and Dean and Jeff and I will be outside meeting people. things. We also pray for our graduates, our Lady of Peace graduates, public school students, Waterson, St. Charles, and Sales. We pray for all our graduates who are going through this unique time. And then finally, our daily Mass schedule, that's going to be remaining the same. So our first public daily Mass will be on Wednesday, June 3rd at 8:30. Oh, and finally, you may notice we didn't pass the collection basket, so we're leaving the basket back now, just letting everybody know. So, and our ushers, of course, will be keeping an eye on that during the Mass. So, thank you again for all of your prayers and contributions. Thank you for being here. It's so good to see you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia.
Alleluia. Thank you.